sleep. Long time no see. I've been posting bits and pieces of my life here, but I find them a little boring and self-serving. The last one about the juvie incidents was already like 70% made up, to my shame. So today, I'll post a recipe instead. This is not creepypasta, at least not yet. And I am writing it from a train in the NYC. What I'm about to share with you today is one of the many relatively safe ways in which you can get access, not quite enter, a place I call the shadow side. And its effectiveness depends on how seriously you take me. Your mileage may vary, refer to title. I won't tell you that you shouldn't be afraid of the shadow side. Chances are you've already seen it after all, and merely think it was just a recurring dream. I tell you, there is no need to be ignorantly afraid of it, though. There is a difference. Ignorance fuels fear, and fear can give that place a lot of juice to run on. You have to be big on preparation if you want to try this. It's like skydiving. If getting it right on your first try is not something you're good at, then this is not for you. If you do drugs or alcohol the night of the event, you're going to have a bad time. If you're going through some serious shit in your life and are not feeling mentally or spiritually stable, or if you're doing this just to escape, you're gonna have a bad time. And if you don't follow my instructions, particularly the multiple backups I'll give you, which, trust me, are there for a reason, you're gonna have a really bad time. The name of this game is the Free Kings. A very large, empty, and quiet room, preferably without windows. If windows exist, you need to be able to cover them and ensure total darkness. Blankets usually work well if they're roomy enough. A pack of candles. You'll only use one if all goes well. And a lighter. A bucket of water in a mug. A fan. Two large mirrors, like the one in your dresser. Don't worry, they won't be harmed. Or if they are, it'll be the least of your concerns. Free chairs. An alarm clock. An active cell phone. Don't forget to charge the goddamn battery. A loved one willing to follow the rules and go along with all the madness. And a small toy or dear object from your childhood. Start setup at around 11 p.m. Place one chair in the center of the room, facing north. This is important. Place the other two chairs exactly to the left and right, facing your throne. The distance between your throne and that of your queen and fool should be about the length of your arm to each side, more or less. Place the two large mirrors on the queen and fool chairs left and right of you, facing you and each other. Try your best to have them stand at a 90 degree angle, or else you may get more or less than free kings. If you sit on your throne facing straight ahead, north, you should be able to perceive your own reflection in each of the two mirrors without actually having to turn your head nor your eyes to do so. If you see your own reflection in the corner of your eye, just barely there, then you've done it right. Place the bucket of water in the mug in front of you, just barely out of reach. Place the fan behind you, turn it on. Don't set it to maximum power. Medium or low is usually enough. Leave it on. Turn off the lights. Leave the door open and go to your bedroom. Set the candles by the side of the bed, next to a lighter, your alarm clock, and your cell phone. Leave it charging. Set your alarm clock for 3:30 a.m. Turn off the lights and sleep while holding your power object. Get some rest. Wake up at 3:30 a.m. with your alarm clock. Turn it off, but don't turn on the light. You have exactly 3 minutes to light your candle, grab your cell phone, and make your way to the dark room to sit in on your throne. You should be seated by 3:33 a.m. Don't forget your power object. Check for potential red flags. If your cell phone didn't charge for whatever reason, abort the mission. If the alarm didn't go off exactly at 3:30 a.m., abort the mission. If you find the dark room door closed, remember you left it open. Abort the mission. If the fan is turned off, you left it on. Abort the mission. Side note, if you have to abort the mission due to any of the above, leave the house of your loved one. Go to a hotel or something. There's no need to run. You have time to grab a jacket and your keys and whatnot. But leave. After 6 a.m., the coast should be clear. If all is going as planned, you can proceed and take your throne. Do not look directly at either of the two mirrors beside you. Do not let the candles go out. The fan is behind you. You must protect the candle with your body, which is standing in between. There's a reason for this, as you'll soon see. Look straight ahead at the darkness, not the candle, not at the mirrors, just straight ahead. Eagle-eyed readers surely noticed I didn't say anything during setup as to which chair was queen and which chair was fool. That's because it's your job to find out. And from their point of view, you are either their queen or their fool. Hence, three kings. I won't spoil what happens next. Suffice to say, you won't be alone, and if you have questions, you'll get answers. Sometimes in the form of new questions, but hey, that's the story of humanity, eh? Just stay put and try not to move. Again, do not look directly at the mirrors, nor the candle. Just straight ahead. Trust me, don't chicken out either. You need to wait until 4:34. By 4:34, it's all over. It's okay to tremble a little bit. Just try not to. Not because it affects the ritual or anything. It's just a pussy thing to do while in polite company. Did I mention not to let the candle go out? That's what the fan is for. You are protecting the candle with your body. But if your body were to be suddenly moved, then the fan would turn off the candle. That's backup number one. Your loved one is backup number two. At 4:34, she has to come into the room and call your name. If that won't work, she has to call your cell phone. If that won't work, she has a glass of water and the bucket. She can't touch you though. That's a newbie mistake. Backup number three is your item of power. The toy, or locket, or whatever object of strength you brought along for the ride. It'll show you the way if shit hits the fan. Multiple backups. You've got to be like a Boy Scout if you do these things. If you half-ass it all the way so that it won't work. Worst you can do is take it seriously enough for it to work, and not seriously enough to be prepared for the consequences. If in doubt, refer to title.